ladies and gentlemen, James Woods.
Thank you. I have this friend who's tremendously successful at what he does, but he still talks like one of the guys. He's extraordinarily normal, and he makes no apologies for it. He's concerned about the world in which he lives, and he writes about making it better in a language that everyone can understand. Now, sometimes he's demanding, occasionally moody, often funny, and always fascinating. His name is Billy Joel, and if anyone could be said to have his finger on the pulse of America, he's the one. Now, as you know, Billy writes in many styles, but the foundation of his music is always a personal experience. One of the strongest influences in his life is the pace and excitement of this city he calls home. New York State of Mind is a song that captures the feeling of someone who has been away too long. Another young artist who captures the feeling vocally was a Grammy nominee for Best Female Rock Performance. And here she is, Melissa Etheridge.
On the Hudson River line.
In his 18-year recording career, Billy Joel has given us songs that deal with important social issues, but always wrapped in a musical package that makes them not only palatable, but popular as well. Finally, Billy remains a true rock and roller, even though he is responsible for some of the most sensitive and romantic observations ever set to music. So what do we have? The amateur boxer who discovered Mozart at the age of 4, the kid who played in piano bars in Los Angeles and captured the hearts and minds of the Russians on their own turf, the songwriter who goes to extremes and married the uptown girl. A medley of contradictions somehow brought into focus in the writing and singing and playing of Billy Joel.
A lot of people think everything Billy Joel writes is autobiographical, but that's not true. He takes a lot from other people's lives. He has the gift of putting himself into their shoes. Billy was brought up in the Levittown part of Long Island during the post-war baby boom. While others were pursuing the middle-class American dream, Billy found his identity in music. It was that passion for music that would draw him to the excitement of big city life.
I'm moving out.
He started playing piano when he was 4. By the time he was 14, he was already a professional musician, meaning he was making money at it in rock bands and roadhouse bands, while other kids his age were still on paper routes. He cut a few records with groups like The Hassles, then later, Attila. Billy became a player because it's what he got the most fun out of doing, even if it meant he had to sacrifice his taste in clothes. Billy got his big break when he moved to California and took a gig playing piano at a lounge in North Hollywood. He went under the name of Bill Martin. One night, a record executive came in. He heard Billy's song, and of course, he loved it. Soon after, Billy signed with Columbia Records. America said, "We'll take you just the way you are." Fine with Billy, because he wasn't about to change for anybody. That independent spirit may be the reason so many people identify with Billy Joel, and why he has been honored with 5 Grammy Awards, including Song of the Year.
Billy Joel has never forgotten where he came from, and in fact, often goes back to the well to find new sources of inspiration. He remembers guys standing on the street corners making music together in the 50s and 60s. Remembers the simple pleasures of creating great harmony on the spot. Well, tonight, some of those guys share that memory with him, and they've brought that street corner indoors, starting with Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons. Please welcome one of the best lead singers from one of the best girl groups in the history of rock and roll, the Ron and the Ronettes, Ronnie Spector.
Say goodbye, my baby.
I'm taking this next group home and having them bronze. Please welcome Dion DiMucci, Benny King, former Temptations David Ruffin and Dennis Edwards, Johnny Gill, Keith Sweat, Graham Nash, and Frankie Valli.
Show. Sponsored by Chevrolet. Today, Chevrolet invites you to see all that's new for 91 and to experience for yourself why more people are winning with the heartbeat of America.
Well, Billy claims that much of his songwriting is the result of happy accidents. Such consistent success cannot be accidental. He is a wonderful interpreter of his own music, but other artists love to sing his songs as well. Take, for example, the Billy Joel song that was Grammy Record of the Year and Song of the Year in 1978. Bill Woods, who played the sax solo on the original recording, joins Bob James on keyboards to accompany one of the brightest young stars of the 1990s, ladies and gentlemen, Regina Bell.
Down before.
They say a musician speaks through his music, but I've always felt it was an added plus to get a musician to speak about his music as well. So who better to speak about Billy Joel than Billy Joel?
I think I'm good at what I do, and if you like what you're doing, that's a big part of it. So what more could I want? To be a musician and to make a living at it is a miracle to begin with. Music is an explosive expression of humanity, something we're all touched by. No matter what culture you're from, everybody loves music. Aside from getting married and having a child, the Soviet trip's the highlight of my life. I can't believe I got to do it because being over there 2 years before the war started coming down in Eastern Europe made the Cold War end a lot sooner for me than for everyone else. I don't believe in using music as a soapbox. I'm not one of those socio-political message guys. I think the best way to do it is to tell a story about human beings, not about issues. And I'm not the guy in a song. I'm only using something called imagination. Vicariously live the guy's life, get a feeling for it. I never lived in Allentown. I never served in Vietnam. I know a lot of guys who did. It's my music that gives them a voice. Sometimes it's tough writing songs. I may be empty for weeks. I got nothing. I'm dry. I walk around like an animal. The piano turns into a beast that dares me to sit down and tame it. I think, this is it. The end of my career, it's all over. And then I click. I don't analyze it. I don't intellectualize it. I just do it. Music enchants me. Since I was 4 years old, I've been playing music. And I don't want to stop doing it now. I just like it too much.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome one of music's most creative and versatile practitioners, Grammy legend, Billy Joel. Billy Joel, for two decades of classic rock performances carried around the world, for compositions that challenge the mind while touching the heart, and for your dedication to the roots of American music, the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences honor you as a Grammy legend. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. First, let me say what an honor it is to be included among the artists here tonight. I was a fan of their music before I recorded any of my own. It's hard to believe that I'm included with them. I want to thank all the artists who performed my songs tonight. I always hope to hear players like Bob James, Phil Woods interpret my stuff, and hear my music sung by real singers. And aside from, you know, what's topical, I mean real singers, I mean vocalists. I don't think of myself as a singer. These people are true vocalists, and so many of them are heroes to me. Dion, Benny King, David Ruffin, Dennis Edwards, Graham Nash. I used to sing street corner harmony to their records, and here they are singing mine. And to a new generation of artists like Melissa Etheridge, Regina Bell, Johnny Gill, and Keith Sweat, to sing my songs means my compositions will continue to live beyond my recording. And finally, for a songwriter to have Frankie Valli and Four Seasons, Ronnie Spector, sing the songs that were written with them in mind, it's the ultimate payback. To my wife, Christy, thank you for... I say that every night. I want to thank you for putting up with all the inconveniences that come with me, but you have been a constant source of great inspiration to me, and you're also responsible for my most successful production, my daughter, Alexa Ray. And finally, I would like to thank my mother, who in a less enlightened time struggled as a single parent to earn a living and provide my sister and myself with a decent home and still managed somehow to pay for piano lessons. She's my living legend.
Billy's been on the road exactly 1 year tonight performing, and he's going back on the road right after this show. So it wouldn't really be fair to ask him to sing a song, but who said life was fair? From that great album, Stormfront, my favorite song of his, and so it goes from the new Grammy legend, Billy Joel.
Choice for mine to make, but you can make. decisions too. And you can have this heart to break.
Welcome once again our Grammy legend for 1990, Johnny Cash. Aretha Franklin. Billy Joel. And Quincy Jones. Over the years are of the highest order, and your achievements serve as a lasting model to everyone in the recording industry. Congratulations to you all. Travel to the season's telecast provided by Continental, which allows one pass members to fly first class to most mainland U.S. cities with a full coach fare. Continental, with first class service that's truly first class. The New York Hilton and Towers at Rockefeller Center, redesigned at a cost of $100 million, is proud to have provided accommodations. The New York Hilton and Towers, it's all in the name. This is Les Marshak speaking.